turning a setback into a comeback. Ron Gustafson, my story.
In fact, my wife of almost 15 years has had to adapt to kind of a strange sense of humor that I carry with me. Julie and I were a couple of college sweethearts going to school out in central Nebraska at Kearney State College, and we got married, and we flew down to the Grand Cayman Islands down the Caribbean on our honeymoon. And Julie and I are both a couple of small-town farm kids, and we hadn't been outside of the state of Nebraska, let alone outside the country. But we flew down to Grand Cayman, and we were having the time of our lives. One afternoon, we were laying out on the beach, soaking up some sun, and I looked out over the ocean, and I saw some people going parasailing. And I looked over to Julie and I said, honey, let's go out on a limb and try this thing called parasailing. And if you all knew my wife, you'd realize that she's not much of a risk taker. So I had to kind of talk her into it, and I finally got the job done. We stood up, we walked down the beach, we bought our tickets, we jump in the boat, and I'm in my swimsuit, Julie's in her swimsuit, and the boat's going out into the ocean, and I noticed this college stud on the back of the boat. And he was getting the sail ready for us, and he was something else. He had that deep, dark, luscious tan. He had the long, flowing blonde hairdo. He had the sporty sunglasses, and he was also sporting an attitude. He was feeling real good about himself. And finally, he got done with the sail, and he jumped off the back of the boat down into where Julie and I were seated. And he looks at me, and with that cocky voice, he said, did you guys remember your shark repellent? I looked him square in the eye, and I said, heck yes, I did. Last time I forgot it, look what happened. He lost his tan and didn't say a word the rest of the trip. At that very moment, my dad was pulling up to the front of the house with a tractor, and he was pulling a feeder wagon behind it. And this was an older tractor, and it didn't have a cab on it. It just had the moon-shaped fenders over the back tires. Dad came to a complete stop, and he signaled for me to jump up on the tractor with him. So I crawled up on the back of that tractor, and I sat on the back right fender, as I had done thousands of times before. Dad put it in gear, and he pulled out to the end of the driveway. He threw it in fifth gear, and we were flying down that gravel road. It was a beautiful, beautiful fall day. The sky was blue, the sun was bright, and the cool fall air was blowing in our faces. I was telling Dad all about my day at school that day, about all the things I had learned in Mr. Mathers' fourth grade classroom, in math and science and history. And I was also bragging to him about all the touchdowns I had scored playing football with my buddies at recess. And I was doing just what I wanted to do, to be out with Dad working on the farm. All of a sudden, we got a quarter of a mile away from the house, and the back axle on the tractor broke, and the back right wheel flew off the tractor, and I was thrown under the tractor where my arm and shoulder were torn off, and my right leg was crushed. Dad was thrown away from the tractor, and he came back up onto the road. My dad picked me up, and as he picked me up, he pressed my shoulder against his chest to slow down some of the bleeding. And he grabbed my right ankle because the only thing that attached my right foot to the rest of my body was a strip of skin an inch wide and a couple of muscles and ligaments. And my dad began to run and scream and cry out for my mom to call the rescue squad. As I looked up at my dad, I saw a very scared look in his eye. And that's a look that I never, ever want to see on anyone's face ever again. And as I was looking up at him, I said, Dad, I want you to know that if I don't make it, that I love you. And please tell Mom and my big brothers that I love them too. Dad continued screaming and crying and running towards the house. And we finally arrived at the house, and he opened up the back door. He walked in, and he laid me down on the living room floor. My mom brought towels out of the kitchen. She stuffed them in my shoulder and wrapped my leg again to slow down some of the bleeding. And there I was, their 9-year-old little boy, literally bleeding to death before my parents' very eyes. There's such challenges in our life, and we have to find the courage to overcome each one of those in a step-by-step process. We have to have that fire burning inside of us that drives us through the next obstacle. Some of the biggest challenges I've ever experienced in my entire life have been that of being a father. Being a mom, being a dad, it's tough work. It's 24 hours a day, it's 7 days a week, and there's no such thing as vacationing from parenting. Isaac was born, our first little baby. We brought him home from the hospital, and he was just so cute. Folks, he was just adorable. His little nose and his ears and his cheeks and that skin, the fingers and toes, he was perfectly made. And I go into his crib, and I put my hand on the top railing of his crib, and I just stare at my little boy sleep hour after hour after hour. And then he filled up his diaper. And I went out of the bedroom and I went down the hallway and I went into the kitchen. I said, Julie, honey, Isaac just filled up his diaper and I only have one arm. I can't change diapers. She didn't buy off on that and I was changing them ever since. You know, it's really hard to get your mouth down on that strap, you know. Is it lunchtime yet? When Isaac was 6 weeks old, I came home early from work one day and I picked up my little bundle of joy and I took him to a customer site to show him off. Folks, I walked into that customer, that office, and I must have been 10 feet tall, just tall and proud. I'm just showing off my new little 6-week-old little baby. So cute. I showed him off and I was getting some great feedback and I was a psycho dad. I just wanted to show him off to the world. I got done showing him off, and I walk out of that office complex. I'm just strolling across the parking lot, just admiring my 6-week-old little bundle of joy. And I got halfway to my car, and I stopped for a moment, and I thought to myself, this is good. Life doesn't get any better than this. It was a late, hot day in June. I'm just strolling across that parking lot, just admiring my little boy. And then I got to my car, and I realized that my car is locked. The keys are in my pants pocket, and I'm holding my 6-week-old little baby. I'm thinking, what in the world am I going to do this time? I thought, well, maybe I can lay him down on the hood of the car for just a second, but no, it was way too hot for that. And then I thought, well, maybe I can lay him down on the parking lot for a second, and I didn't want to be arrested for that. What in the world was I going to do? So I threw him up. I got my keys out. Just kidding.